story to tell. On the Syrian battlefield, the Su-24 is the combat aircraft with the most numbers, accounting for one-third of the total number of Russian aircraft here. This aircraft has been involved in many local armed conflicts and has many casualties. However, until now, the Su-24 remains the main Russian frontline bomber, although it has been gradually replaced by the modern Su-34. Development of a new attack aircraft operating in all weather, day and night, began in the Soviet Union in the early 1960s. At first, the Sukhoi Design Bureau experimented with the Su-7 bomber and converted the Su-15 into a strike. For many reasons, the project failed. A new project began with the designation T-6, an aircraft with a variable squib wing, twin engines, and a side-by-side seating arrangement for its crew of two, making it easier to interact with each other. In February 1975, the aircraft entered service as the Su-24, equipped with advanced navigation and observation systems. It was equipped with a powerful computer at the time that allowed the Su-24 to fly low altitude following the terrain fault. In terms of design, without a doubt, the Soviet design was inspired by the impressive and powerful squib wing design of the US F-111. The fuselage is all metal, has no studs, and therefore very stiff. The Su-24 measures 22.53 meters long, a wingspan of 17.64 meters at spread, and 10.37 meters when squared. Its empty weight is 22.3 tons. And maximum takeoff weight is 43.75 tons. What makes the Su-24 so special is its wings, which high-mounted. The preset wing squib positions were noted as 16, 35, 45, and 69 degrees. The variable geometric wing provides excellent short takeoff and landing performance, allowing a landing speed of 230 km per hour, even lower than the Sukhoi Su-17, despite substantially greater takeoff weight. Its high wing loading provides a stable low-level ride and minimal gust response. The Su-24 is powered by two Lyorka AL-21F 3A turbojet engines with 75 kN drive thrust each and 109.8 kN with afterburner. It can reach a top speed of 1,654 km per hour at high altitude and 1,315 km per hour at sea level. The combat range is 615 km, service ceiling is 11,000 meters, and the rate of climb is 150 meters per second. The Su-24 can perform complex aerial acrobatics. The plane confidently flies upright, dives, turns, complex maneuvers in aerial combat. It can effectively engage enemy radars when breaking through air defenses to destroy ground targets. Ten fatal accidents occurred during Su-24 deployment, killing 13 Sukhoi and Soviet Air Force test pilots. By the late 1980s, the Soviet Air Force received the Su-24M version, equipped with new navigation and observation equipment, along with an aerial refueling system. Su-24M can carry almost all types of aviation weapons, including air-to-air missiles, air-to-ground missiles, bombs. The combat payload is more than 8 tons. From the 2000s, appeared Su-24M2, the latest modernized version. Su-24 has a high accident rate. Part of the reason for this is because the bomber weighed about 20 tons, but acted more like a fighter or strike aircraft. Su-24 produced nearly 1,400 units. It participates in all armed conflicts involving the Soviet Union and Russia, and has been used successfully abroad. During the operation in Syria, these bombers accurately attacked ISIS targets, although they were losses. That is cool. Overall, however, the aircraft has proven itself to be a machine capable of operating in a variety of climatic conditions. The base Su-24s have been withdrawn from service in the Russian Federation, while the Su-24M, M2, and Su-24MR are still in service. An increasing number of Su-34s are in service with the Russian Aerospace Force. For now, however, the Su-24 will remain in service, although it may only perform reconnaissance and jamming functions. The closest foreign rival of its class to the Su-24 was the US F-111 tactical bomber, which had been in operation since 1967 and had fought in Vietnam, Libya, during Operation Desert Storm in Iraq, but withdrew from service in the middle 1990s. Other similar aircraft include the Panavia Tornado of Europe and the Sain JH-7 of China. My video about the Su-24 answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos. Đâu vào đây nhé.